Good evening, everyone. Welcome you all to the second day of National Workshop on Outcome-Based Learning. Let us begin today's session with a silent prayer. I welcome our resource person, Dr. Manishankar S, to today's session. Today's session is on attainment evaluation and mapping, which is the most important part of outcome-based education. I welcome you, sir. I also welcome our dear principal, Dr. M.R. Renuka, IQAC coordinator, Dr. Preeti K.N., and all the heads of the department of SBRNSS College and faculty members, and all the participant teachers from all over India. I welcome you all once again, and over to you, sir. You can begin the session now.
Okay. Thank you. Am I audible clearly?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So in yesterday's session, we were just seeing a brief idea about what is outcome-based education. But today's, so I request madam to share the PPT.
Sure.
Yeah, so we were trying to find out what is attainment. So attainment endana nammal manasilakkanadana. Attainment endu paranjal, എത്ര ശതമാനം നമ്മുടെ ക്ലാസ്സിലെ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് നമ്മൾ കീപ്പ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു ടാർഗറ്റ് ടാർഗറ്റ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഒരു മാർക്കോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ഇത്ര ശതമാനത്തിന് മേലെ ഒരു ഇപ്പം നമ്മുടെ ഒരു എൻ സെമിസ്റ്റർ എക്സാം നമ്മുടെ ഫൈനൽ യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി എക്സാം ഒരു 80 മാർക്കിനാണ് ഓക്കെ അതിൽ 40 മാർക്കിന് മുകളിൽ എത്ര ശതമാനം കുട്ടികൾ വരും എന്നുള്ളത് നമ്മൾ കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നതാണ് നമ്മൾ എന്ത് പറയുന്നത് അറ്റൈൻമെന്റ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഓക്കെ അത് ഡിഫറെന്റ് ലെവൽസ് ഓഫ് അറ്റൈൻമെന്റുകൾ ഉണ്ടാകാം കാൻ യു ഗോ ടു ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് സ്ലൈഡ്സ് വൺ മോർ നെക്സ്റ്റ് നെക്സ്റ്റ് മേ ബി സ്ലൈഡ് നമ്പർ 28 ഐ സപ്പോസ് ലിറ്റിൽ മോർ ഫോർവേഡ് സോ നമ്മൾ ഇവിടെ കണ്ടത് നമ്മൾ ഇന്നലെ ആർട്ടിക്കുലേഷൻ മാട്രിക്സ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു ആർട്ടിക്കുലേഷൻ മാട്രിക്സ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മുടെ ഓരോ സിഒയും അതിന്റെ കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് പിഒയും ആയിട്ടുള്ള എത്രത്തോളം കോറിലേഷൻ ആണെന്നുള്ള നമ്മൾ കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്തത് അപ്പൊ അതിന് നമ്മൾ 3 ലെവൽ പറഞ്ഞു 3 എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ മാക്സിമം കോറിലേറ്റിംഗ് ആണ് 2 എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ മീഡിയം കോറിലേറ്റിംഗ് ആണ് 1 എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ കോറിലേഷൻ തീരെ കുറവാണെന്നാണ് ബട്ട് അല്ലാത്തതിന് നമ്മൾ ഡാഷ് മാർക്ക് ചെയ്യും എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ കോറിലേഷൻ ഇല്ല എന്നർത്ഥം അപ്പം എല്ലാ പിഒക്കും എല്ലാ സിഒയുമായി കോറിലേഷൻ ഉണ്ടാവണം നിർബന്ധമില്ല അതാണ് നമ്മൾ മനസ്സിലാക്കേണ്ട ആദ്യ കാര്യം അപ്പൊ നമ്മളൊരു കോഴ്സ് പ്ലാൻ എഴുതുമ്പോൾ നമ്മുടെ സൈക്കിൾ എഴുതുമ്പോൾ ആദ്യം അതിൽ നമ്മൾ സിഒ എഴുതണം അതിനകത്ത് പ്രോഗ്രാം ഔട്ട്കം എഴുതണം അതിനുശേഷം നമ്മൾ ഈ ആർട്ടിക്കുലേഷൻ മാട്രിക്സ് വരയ്ക്കണം അതിനനുസരിച്ച് നമ്മൾ തീരുമാനിക്കും എത്രത്തോളം ഡെപ്തിൽ നമ്മളത് പഠിപ്പിക്കാൻ പോകുന്നു അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എത്രത്തോളം റെലവൻസ് ഉണ്ട് എന്നുള്ളത് അപ്പൊ അതനുസരിച്ചാണ് നമ്മൾ മാർക്ക് ഇടുക 3, 2, 1 ത്രീ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ മോർ റെലവൻസ് എന്നുള്ള രീതിയിൽ ചെയ്യുന്ന വെയ്റ്റഡ് ആവറേജ് എന്ന് പറയും വെയ്റ്റഡ് ആവറേജ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഒരു പിഒയും അതിന്റെ കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് സിഒയും തമ്മിൽ എത്രത്തോളം വേരിയേജ് എന്നുള്ള കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ആണ് അപ്പൊ നമ്മളെടുത്ത റോ നോക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് കാണാം എന്താണ് ഈ ഫസ്റ്റ് റോ PO1 ഫസ്റ്റ് കോളം കോളം നോക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് കാണാം നമ്മൾ എന്താഡ് ചെയ്യും 2+3+3+3+2 അത് ആഡ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് അതിനെ നമ്മൾ ആറ് കൊണ്ട് ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് കിട്ടുന്ന വെയ്റ്റഡ് ആവറേജ് 2.67 ആണ് ഓക്കെ സോ അങ്ങനെ നമ്മൾ ഓരോ വെയ്റ്റഡ് ആവറേജും നമ്മൾ കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യും കാൽക്കുലേഷൻ ഫോർ ദ വെയ്റ്റഡ് ആവറേജ് വെയ്റ്റഡ് ആവറേജ് വി കൻ സീ ദാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് 2+3+3+2 divided by 6, which we get it as 2.67. Similarly, for PO2, we calculate. Similarly, for all PO and PSO, we calculate the weighted average. Can we just go to the next part of the slide? Yeah, so here, what we do is finally write the weighted average in total, and we try to, what is our achieved target? Okay, for PO1, I have achieved 3, but my weighted average was 2.67. So I will finally try to calculate that whether I attained that particular weighted average or not. So that is what is the calculation of an articulation matrix going to be. So articulation matrix is nothing but we map the CO1s, each CO to its PO, and we calculate the weighted average of each of the. So this is a mandatory thing we have to do in our course plan, because then only we will come to know how much we have to attain. Okay, so this is a kind of a reference point we are going to keep. So going to the next slide. Yeah, so here what we are going to basically tell is what is our assessment procedure going to be, or assessment pattern. So if you are clear with this assessment pattern, then definitely we are going to be very clear with how we are going to do the mapping. Okay, so we have two parts according to OBE. One is direct attainment. Direct attainment means what all examinations we conduct for student, where student is given an evaluation component. Like in your case, there is two internal examinations, as I understand, first internal and second internal, which may be done for 40 marks, which you cut down finally into 5 marks, totally 10 marks. Okay, so that is the first internal and second internal. Then there may be a seminar or assignment given for 5 marks, attendance for 5 marks, total your internal. Further, we will be noting it as IE. IE is going to be 20 marks. Okay, then end semester of university examination is marked as 8 marks. So total 80 plus 20 is 100 marks, which is direct assessment, means the student has taken that evaluation. So that is what we call as direct assessment. So what is indirect assessment? That is, we give some kind of survey. So this is a very important procedure. Each course teacher has to prepare a survey based on the COs. So yesterday I told you one CO is like writing an essay. Okay, where the student is able to write an essay. So if I give a question like that, how good you are at writing essays? So I give a survey question to the student. Okay, then the student, what he will do, he will rate it in a scale of 3. Same again, everywhere we are using the scale of 3. So if 3 means he has understood the writing essay very well, he is able to do it very well, so he will give 3. If it is 2 means medium, again 1 means minimum. So he will give us a feedback in the scale of 3, or what we can do, we can convert it into 10, at a scale of 10, then later on break it into 3 scales. Say we can do, but better if you do 3-1, it's easy for us. So this has to be done by each course teacher at the end of the course. Just before your university exam, we should share a feedback form about our course and correlating questions based on our each of the course outcomes. That is what we call as indirect assessment. So I hope all of you are clear with two parts, direct and indirect. Direct assessment means what all exams we do. Indirect means survey we conduct. Can we go to the next slide? Yeah, so here also we can see that our 20% just previous slide, 20% is from internal examination, 80% is from 100%. out of that 90% is from direct attainment, 10% is from indirect. So indirect we give a very light weightage because we know our level of students will not be able to assess teachers very well. So that is why we have given 10. But in foreign countries, all they may give 20% weightage to the indirect attainment because their students are more capable of assessing the teachers. So if we find our students are assessing well, we can increase the percentage of indirect survey marks. Survey marks can be more. Okay, survey marks here I have kept only 10%. 90% is from our exam procedure. Okay, that is clear for everybody, I think. 90, 10, 80, 20 also we can do. There is no problem. And in the direct, 20 is from the internal examination, 80 is from the external. Like that, I can divide. So going to the next slide. Yeah, so here, how I set the target level. Target level means for each exam, how I set a target level. Target level means this much percentage, how much of my students will go above this percentage. That is what I want to clearly come to know. I told you already how much percentage of students will cross the barrier. So that barrier how I set is the target level I am setting here. So it is done based on questions also. It can be done based on exam also. So here I am taking first internal. I told first internal finally converted to 5 marks. Okay. Am I right? First internal is finally converted into 5 marks. Is it right? Is it 5 marks first internal? The 40 marks is going to convert into 5 marks. Okay. So that 5 marks, I am going to set a target as 60%. So 0.6 into 5. Okay, which is finally 3 marks. So how many students are able to score more than 3 marks in the first 5 mark? That is what I am going to correlate as a target level. So target level, I may fix it as 60% or 50% or 40% depending on my student. It is a teacher's freedom. Okay, teacher may set it as a target. Clear? So 0.6 is 60%. 60% into how much mark question or how much mark exam? 5 marks exam. So how many are going to above 3? So if 60 to 79% of my students are scoring more than 3 marks, then I call it as level 1 attainment. So here also 3 levels. According to Washington, everything is 3 levels. So first level I am telling 60 to 79%. This may change from exam to exam. We may put some 40 to 50% of students as level 1. That is our freedom. But definitely level 1 means 60 to 70% of students score more than 3 marks. Okay, level 2 means 80 to 89% of students score more than. More than 90% score more than 3 marks means my level is 3. So I can set the target level for each exam as well as each question. So this is very important to set the target to tell that whether my attainment is reaching or not. Okay. So I first set a levels. So levels are like 60 to 79, 80 to 89 or more than 90% I am going to set. Okay, then for another assignment, for example, assignment plus attendance, out of 10 mark I am keeping again 0.6 into 10, 6 marks. So how many are going more than 6 marks I am taking in that assignment? So here we can see level 1 is 60 to 79. 80 to 89 greater than 90. So if some student, none of the students are coming above 6 marks means there is no attainment for the course. But you need not worry. Maybe it is wrong due to our exam procedure. Maybe the university exam, sometimes that kind of things may happen. Our students only 2 or 3 may set the target level and pass. So that may very well happen to us. But we have to, for internal it is always we can set a proper target level, and according to the target level we can teach them and see that whether that many number of students crosses our marks or not. So if level 1 means 60 to 79, level 2 means 80 to 89, level 3 means greater than 90. Can we go to the next slide? Yeah, in case of end semester, what happens? End semester is out of 80 marks, which I am going to put a 40 marks. It is a relative pass, I am going to tell. So in all MG University, I am going to take the results of various colleges of NSS, various other colleges under like MG University, and I am going to set a target. What is my target? Either I am going to set a target as 40 marks or the 50% of my total examination. So I am putting 40 marks as my target. So how many students score more than 40? So here I am bringing my cutoff low because I know it is a university exam, and we don't have much control over the questions or things. So I think 50% of our students score more than 40 means I have level 1 attainment. Comparing the different other one, internal I had put the target slightly upper, from 60 to 79, 79 to 89, then I had put above 90, but here I am putting only 50%, 60%, 70%. If 70% of my class scores more than 40 means I have level 3. Level 3 means maximum attainment. They have understood the subject very well. So attainment only means that how many number of my students will cross the particular cutoff or not. Okay, so I told initially there are two type of exam, direct exam and indirect. Indirect means survey, direct means our this assignments, our internal exams, then end semester exam or university exam. So together is direct. Okay, I hope all of you are clear with the direct and indirect. Any doubts in that direct indirect assessment? Please tell me.
Sir, indirect assessment cheyunnundo?
Indirect assessment cheyunnundu, kaaran indirect assessment cheytha maatrame student inde perspective manasilavullu. Means
yana Kerala University nana LMG University le usle procedure cheyunnundo nu ariyan vendi chesu.
അല്ല, ഇപ്പൊ എവിടെയും ഒരു ഒരു സ്ഥലത്ത് ഇപ്പൊ ചെയ്തു വരുന്നില്ല, ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോ ചെയ്യേണ്ടി വരും.
അല്ല, ഇപ്പൊ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇപ്പൊ കഴിഞ്ഞ വർഷം നാഷ് ആയിരുന്നു, കാരണം ഒത്തിരി ഫീഡ്ബാക്ക്സ് ഒരുപാട് കാര്യങ്ങൾ ചെയ്തു, പക്ഷെ ആ കൂട്ടത്തിൽ നിങ്ങളുടെ അസസ്മെന്റ് ചെയ്തിട്ടില്ല, അതാ ചോദിച്ചത്.
അത് ഇപ്പൊ ഒബിയുടെ പ്രൊസീജിയർ പ്രകാരം രണ്ടു തരം അസസ്മെന്റ് ഉണ്ടെന്നാണ് അവര് പറയുന്നത്. ചിലപ്പോ നമ്മള് 100 മാർക്സും ഡയറക്റ്റ് അറ്റൈൻമെന്റ് ആയിട്ട് ചെയ്താലും കുഴപ്പമില്ല.
Okay, sir.
But to make it a better, we can have this 90-10, 80-20. Some minimum weightage to student perspective.
Okay, sir.
Similarly, this attainment levels also plays a vital role. Attainment level means for that particular exam, what I am going to set as a first pass mark. Okay, then how many of my set of students, 60%, 70%, 90%, I am going to consider they cross that cutoff. So that cutoff is teacher's freedom definitely, or there is something what we call as a DAC, Departmental Academic Advisory Committee. Now according to NAC or any accreditation body, they want a apex body in the department which we call as Department Academic Advisory Committee. Actually, that committee will be steering the process of OBE, means checking whether all teachers do the course accord, means their course delivery according to CO or PO, or whether they are doing the mapping, or whether they are conducting exam according to that. And finally, they give suggestions. What suggestions they give? That your target is low, I have put 30 marks out of 80 as a target. So next time they will tell you have to put a higher target, 50 marks as your target, so that you have to teach, you have to add some assessment component to it. You may have to do some exercise specifically. Some area student may not have understood, that area you have to teach. Like that, there may be a committee formed in the department, which we call as Department Academic Advisory or Academic Audit Committee. Both the names may be used according to NAAC terminology. So this, I think, generally those who are going according to the new NAAC cycle may have heard it, what is called as a DAC. Okay, so coming to the next slide. Yeah, so here what I'm going to do is each of this particular thing. So here I have marked as class test or assignment or our internal exam. Let me call as internal exam. So if I have, if in my first internal exam, instead of class test one, you think it as first internal exam. In the first internal exam, my attainment level is 2. Attainment level is 2 means, going back, we can see it is 70 to 79% of my students have got more than the target. What was my target? 6 marks out of 10. I have, those people have scored. So I have got attainment level 2. So how to calculate the attainment level, I will come to tell you. But here I have put. And in external examination, I can see that this is corresponding to each of the CO. So already I told what are all COs. CO means course outcome. So first course outcome was about essay writing. Okay, let us take it as about essay writing or calculating determinant of matrix or some matrix operation. If I take first CO, so first CO is asked in the assignment, okay, as well as it is asked in the external examination also, some part. And or in the second case, above 70% of students have answered that particular part of the question correctly. But here in university, maybe those who are setting university question paper, you know that nowadays they have slowly changed the pattern. Previously, they don't follow this CO, PO or scaling at all. So at that time, there may be a problem in calculating the external assessment, but we have to just put a pass mark. Like how we did 40 marks, just put a pass mark and see how much percentage of my students come above that 40 marks. So here I could see that this many people come, how much, 80 to 89% comes. So I have got 3 as my attainment level. So what I do is, now I apply the equation. Point two of my internal, so 0.2 into 2 plus 0.8 into 3 plus external attainments average into the variages. So what was my first CO? First CO is about writing an essay. So internal exam, my students for the question where I have given to write essay, almost some 70 to 79% of students have done it correctly. So there we have got this mark 2, level 2 attainment. Whereas in the other case, level 3. So now I multiply it, 0.2 into 2, 0.4 plus 0.8 into 3, I get 2 point something. So totally I get average score like 2.6. Like that I may get an average. Means there are two parts for each CO. What I will generally try to do is, I will have some questions coming in the first internal exam. So first internal exam, 40 marks in the anangil, out of that 10 marks may be from CO1. Okay, so for that 10 marks, how much of my students have scored more than 60%? If they have scored more than 60%, I will get the level attainment as 1. If they have crossed more than 80% my level will be 2. If they have scored more than 90% my level will be 3. So here for CO1 I have got a level as 2. Similarly, in end semester, out of 80 marks, my CO question may only come for some 10 marks, okay, or 20 marks. My CO question may only come. CO1 means essay writing question, okay. Essay writing I have asked in the final university exam, which I call as end semester. I have only asked 20 marks of 2 essays I would have asked in the university exam. So those 2 essays, my students, all of them have tried to attempt and they have scored. That is why my level is 3, means more than 90% or more than 70%, because end semester we had put a target as 70% as 3. So more than 70% of students could do essay writing. I am taking an example, essay writing or some kind of trigonometric calculation or some kind of like optics. It is a question from optics. First things, basics of optics is CO1. So most of my students have understood the basics of optics and they were able to answer the questions asked from that. So that is why I got a level of attainment as 3. Okay. So what I do now is 2 into 0.2. 0.2 means my weightage of my internal exam is only out of 1, 0.2. Okay. And external weightage out of 1 is 0.8. So 0.2 into 2 plus 0.8 into 3. I am going to multiply like that. So I get an average CO value of both combined internal and external. So internal and external are separate exams. We may have calculated how many number of students crossed that and put a score like 1, 2, 3. We would have put the scores as 1, 2, 3. Now what I am going to do is I am going to average both the things together. How much of internal, how much of external. So I get a total CO attainment score. So total attainment score, can anybody can calculate and tell me? 0.2 into 2 plus 0.8 into 3. Similarly for... So similarly for next CO2, I have to multiply 1 into 0.2 plus 3 into 0.8. Similarly for next third CO I will be doing. So similarly I will be doing for all the 6, 7, 8 COs which I have. So this is what we call as CO attainment. Course outcome attainment. Course outcome attainment is nothing but each course, each thing, each outcome. Each outcome means we are going to measure it based on the questions asked from that outcome. So for example, optics, this many number of questions are from optics. Or in economics, some foundations of economics is first CO. How many questions were there from foundation of economics? So that many number of questions, how much percentage of my students attended? So attainment is not based on mark. Attainment is how much percentage of our students will cross that cutoff we have put. Okay, so that is very important for us. Clear for all of you? We are going to put a threshold. Target is mark. Threshold is telling 60 to 70% of my students will cross the target mark. Target mark is 6. Okay. In my class, out of 24 students or out of 60 students, I have a class of 60 students. Out of that, 30 students score more than 6 mark. It is 50%. Okay. 50% means I don't achieve a target according to level I have put before. So before level. But if 35 students means 60 to 79, which is level 1. So I get a mark as level 1. If it is above 40, 45 means I will get a level 2. If it is above 50 students out of 60 are scoring, I get a level 3. So for a particular CO, the question which I have asked, from that I have to take. So how to map the CO and question? Parvati miss, can you share that one word file I have sent you? Bloom's taxonomy, one word file I have sent you. Can you share the word file? The next one, the word file. Yeah. So here, in our exam procedure, we should try to map each of our course outcome to each of the questions. Can we scroll it little down? Yeah. So what I do is, I put the first question and corresponding CO number I am going to map. So for all internal exam question paper, I am going to follow this, or the teacher is going to do this. They are going to write the question. Then what is this 2, 5 and all is Bloom's taxonomy level. So I am going to fix the Bloom's taxonomy level. Then I am going to enter the CO. So for first question, it may be CO1. Second question, it may be CO2. Third question, it may be CO3. And the taxonomy level. So like this, if I prepare a question paper, then at the time when I get the result, it is very easy for me to evaluate. So basically, there may be part one is out of 2 mark questions may be there. Part two is 5 mark questions may be there. Part three. So I should write the marks of the part as well as the taxonomy level as well as the CO level. All the three things I have to mark. Here they have only marked the marks as well as CO. But in original, when we do, we mark the how much mark question it is. What is the CO mapping to that? Then what is the Bloom's taxonomy level for the question? So all the three we have to mark. So here I have 2 marks and 5 marks question. For example, if I am conducting a 40 marks exam, I may have some 5 descriptive questions for 25 marks. Then some 15 marks, I may have some objective questions in that. So like that, I will divide the but every CO should be mapped. So what basically we are going to do is, wherever CO1 is there, I am going to calculate the total CO1 marks of particular exam. Okay, so CO1 is about essay writing or about optics or about some trigonometry, something. So that CO1, there are 5 questions, some 3 2 marks questions, so 6 marks, and 2 5 marks questions, so 10 marks. So 10 plus 6, 16 marks came from first CO. So that is what I am going to tell, 16 marks came from first CO. Then I take the next CO, CO2. Out of CO2, another 10 marks came from CO2. Then again I take another CO, maybe 10 marks came from that. Another CO, 14 marks came. So out of 4 COs, this is the total sheet we can see. Totally we tabulate and find and see this much mark came from all the COs. Okay, so that is what, how we set a question paper. Descriptive or objective, what we have to do, we have to enter those. So this is a procedure all the teachers should follow, then only it will become easy for us. Or after we conduct an exam, we think and we try to map it back, it is very difficult. So nammal question paper set cheyumba thanne oru question edu CO il ninnaanu varunnathu, അതുപോലെ എത്ര മാർക്കിന്റെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആണ്, ഏത് ബ്ലൂംസ് ടാക്സോണമി ലെവലാണെന്ന് എഴുതി കഴിഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ, നമ്മൾ ആ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ പേപ്പർ മൊത്തമായി എടുത്തു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമുക്ക് ആ കാൽക്കുലേഷൻ ചെയ്യാൻ എളുപ്പമായിരിക്കും. ടോട്ടൽ CO1 ൽ നിന്നും 15 മാർക്ക് വന്നു, CO2 ൽ നിന്നും 15 മാർക്ക് വന്നു, അപ്പൊ 30 മാർക്കായി. പിന്നെ 10 10 മാർക്ക് ഇറ്റ് ഹാസ് കം ഫ്രം CO3 ഓർ CO4, 5 5 മാർക്സ് കേം. അങ്ങനെ 40 മാർക്ക് 4 സിഒകളിൽ നിന്ന് വന്നു നമ്മൾ കണ്ടുപിടിക്കും. അതിനനുസരിച്ച് ആ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യനുകൾ ഏത് സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് ആണ് ആൻസർ ചെയ്തതെന്ന് നമ്മൾ കണ്ടുപിടിക്കണം. വിച്ച് ഓൾ ദോസ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ഹൗ മെനി നമ്പർ ഓഫ് സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് അറ്റംപ്റ്റഡ് വി ഹാവ് ടു ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട്. സോ നൗ വിൽ ഗോ ബാക്ക് ടു ദ PPT. മാം, കാൻ വി ഗോ ബാക്ക് ടു ദ PPT? So now you would have understood how I got each CO wise the number of questions or not. Coming to the next slide. So what I do is I will generally make a sheet like this for direct descriptive exam. Descriptive exam means which are of like written questions out of 5 marks and all I conduct. So what I do is I have some 14 students here. There may be set also when we conduct different set also may be there, and all the questions are not optional. So here it is, out of 10 marks there are only 2 questions they have to mandatorily attend. All students must attend 2 questions only. So what we do is the first question is from CO1, the second question is from CO2, the third question is from CO2, the fourth question is from CO3. So out of 10 mark, how the division has happened, or out of 40 marks also we have to write like this: CO1, CO2, CO3, CO4 or CO6. Maybe 6 COs are there, means CO6 we have to write. And which all questions, how many have attempted, because we have a choice for each questions. If there was no choice, it is very easy for us. We can directly take how many number of students attempt, means totally number of students attempted, number of students scoring more than the cutoff mark. So if I have put the 5 mark question, my cutoff is 3, means I am putting it as 6%, 60%. My cutoff is 3. I am able to see the marks. If you are able to see, you can see the marks. CO1, one student has scored 4, 5, 5, 5, 1, 5. So totally how many students attempted? 7 students attempted, and out of that 6 of them have scored more than 3. Okay, try to understand. Out of 7 students, 6 of them have attempted above 7. So what is my percentage? Percentage is 85%, and my level is 2. My level is from, we told 70 to 89 is one level, okay, or 80 to 89 is level 2, 60 to 79 was level 1. So 85.7 is level 2. So I got this value. So you are all asking me how I got the level 2 for that internal examination in the previous slide. This is how we get. What we have to do, we have to write all the students, then we have to write all their marks based on each question, because each question may come from different COs. So like that, we have to take out a complete sheet and find number of students attempted, number of students crossing the threshold mark. What was threshold marks? 3 marks. So how many crossed 3 marks? 6 of them. So 6 by 7, 85.71 is the thing. So that's why I told, if you have your sheet, then it is very easy that all of you can calculate it parallelly. Next, question 2, what we do? Question 2, only 3 have attempted. All the 3 have got more than the threshold marks, right? Question 3, 3 of them only attended. All the 3 got more than the mark. So it is 100%. So my attainment level is 3. For question 3, out of 8 attempted, all 8 have got more than threshold, because all of their marks are 5. So I got 100% attainment level also there. There also it is level 3. For question 4, if I see, out of 8, 7 students have crossed the threshold. What was my threshold? 3 marks, because I kept it as 60. So 60 into 0.6 into 5 was 3 marks. So 87.5 is my threshold there. I got level 2. So now I got for each of the COs, what is my desired level? 2, 3, 3, 2. But here CO2 is coming 2 times, right? CO2 is coming 2 times. So I should average the CO2 values. Maybe in original case, CO2 may come in 4 or 5 questions. So what I should do for each question score, I should take, if there are 4 questions, and my levels in the 4 questions are like 3, 3, 2, 1. Then I should add 3 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. So 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 2, 8 plus 1, 9 by 4. So that is my score, some 2.5. I should get it as my CO score. So very easy procedure. What we have to do is we have to write the roll numbers, then each question and the corresponding CO mapping. Where we got the CO mapping? We got the CO mapping from where we written down the question paper, the previous question paper. I saw, I got the weightage as well as the CO1. Then what I am going to see, how many of my students attempted it, how many of the students crossed it. So that number I have to see clearly in each of this question. So if I am able to see those kind of things, then I can calculate the number of students crossing that threshold. So this is the procedure of attainment of course calculation. So each internal exam, out of 40 marks, I should draw a chart like this. I should enter each question, how many students attempted the question. For that question, I should keep a threshold, and how many scored more than threshold, then I will get for each CO what is my value. And if there are multiple questions with same CO, I should take the average of those COs. So this is a little, if you try to understand, it's a little tough procedure, but if you, once you understand, it's very easy. Okay, because basically all our autonomous colleges, we have been doing it. So it is a procedure you have to try to follow. So I hope all of you are somewhat clear. There will be still confusion, but please ask me if there is anything more, if I want to explain anything more to add here. What is a CO attainment? This is for a 10 mark exam. There are 2 5-mark questions. For each 5-mark question, there are choices. That is why 4 questions came like that. So maybe in your 40 marks also, there may be choice questions also. So that also we have to take care properly. And here we can see the best of 2 scores only we take for the final 10 marks. So in the last column, we can see best of 2 scores we are taking. So I hope you are clear with the CO attainment. CO attainment means we write the CO question, then we take how many number of students attempted, how many crossed our target. Our target was 3. Out of that, 6 students crossed it. So like that, we have to set. So going to next slide. Similarly, this is for an objective exam. So here also we can see what is the objective or kind of assignment. Assignment, all of them have got 5, 5, 5, 5. So this is how objective plus assignment together I calculate. Can we go to the next slide? So this is how the total mark will look like. So my total, next page, total I can see here, out of 49 students attempted, 33 of them scored my out of 15 what target I kept. I may kept a target as 10. Then out of 49, 33 of my students got about 10 marks. So what is my 33 by 49? 67.34. According to my internal first exam, this is my first exam. First exam may be for 15 mark or 40 marks. So out of 40 marks, my total, how I got 67.34, which I am marking it as 1 mark. So sorry, level 1. Level 1 means 67.34 according to me. Okay. Similarly, the next exam, how many of them are there? There are 49 students, 38 of them have attempted. So it is 77.5. So what I do, I have to total grade, maybe grade point also I can take. 49 by 35, it is 71.42, it is level 3. In end semester, out of 75, so totally I write a complete Excel sheet. Where what I will enter? I will enter the marks in first internal, second internal, assignment, attendance, then end semester. Then what I do? I keep a cutoff. Okay, according to the cutoff, I will see total students are 50. Out of that 30 score, so 30 by 50, I take it as a percentage. That percentage, what I will check, which level it is mapping to. So that is the only procedure each teacher has to do. Each teacher has to take all the marks, put a threshold cutoff, maybe based on each CO. But end semester and all, we cannot base it on CO because end semester is not in our hand. So we may have to just put a target level and put the calculation. Okay, so what basically we do is number of students attempted, number of students crossing my threshold, we have to just put it. So if we put and calculate it, we will be able to get the attainment levels, various attainments levels. So according to that attainment level, total what is my attainment level, I will get internal exam, external exam, end semester exam. So that is the procedure of calculating an attainment. Going to the next slide. So this is for indirect attainment. So indirect attainment, I told you it is from survey. So what I do is I have written a formula there. We can see it as for this particular course, level 1 into number of students. Level 2, how many answered into number of students. Level 3, how many answered into number of students. By total number of students will give me CO attainment level of an indirect exam. So out of my 40 students, for example, here there is total participants are 33. Okay, for CO1 we can see total participants are 33. Out of them, some of two of them have answered level 1. Level 1 means they have understood very lightly. Slight understanding is there. 12 of them have medium understanding, 19 of them have given high understanding. So what I do, 2 into 1 plus 2 into 12 plus 33 into 3 divided by what is the total number, 33. So I get a score 2.52. So what I am going to do, how many students in level 1 into 1? How many students in level 2 into 2? How many students in level 3 into 3? Totally, I divide it with the total number of students. I get an indirect attainment level. So this now, it may be a little difficult for you to understand. But once you practice, very easy. What you have to do? You have to just put it in an Excel sheet and write a formula. 2 into 1. Number of students 12 into 2, 19 into 3, totally divided by 33. So I get a score. So similarly for each of this question, I have to, for CO6, if I see one student only answered level 1. So 1 into 1 plus 12 into 2, 24 plus 20 into 3, 60 divided by 33. So 60 plus 24 plus 1. So 60 plus 35, 95 by 33. 2.58, I get a score for each of this indirect. Indirect means based on survey. Survey only 3 levels, 1, 2, 3. 1 means slightly understanding, 2 means medium, 3 means high understanding level. Then what we have to do, just we have to map and multiply it. But really to tell, once you practice only, you will be able to understand it. Till the time I practice also, I had practiced also. I also thought it's a very tough process. But once I did one course, if I do, I will be able to, one subject I do, then I will be able to do all my subjects very easily. So that is what is about outcome-based attainment. This is indirect. Previous was direct. Now to the next slide. Now we can see both. So what is my direct attainment of CO? I should go back to the slide and see. My direct attainment is 3. Okay, then indirect attainment is 2.58. Then I have to multiply 0.9 into DA. 0.9 means what was my 90% is from direct attainment. 1% is from indirect attainment. So I have to multiply and write. So you can use this kind of a sheet to calculate overall CO. Overall attainment is calculated from each of the direct attainment CO into 0.9. 0.9 means 90% I have given the weightage. So weightage is very important. 0.1 means 1% weightage I have given. So I multiply the 0.9 into DA plus 0.1 into indirect attainment IDA. I get the total average CO attainment. I hope all of you are clear with this direct and indirect. Previously, we calculated for each CO direct. In the previous slide, we calculated indirect. Now we have to just multiply with this formula. We get an average CO attainment for the particular subject. So this much we have to do for a subject. We have to write a CO. We have to write the PO. We have to do the articulation matrix. Then we have to set a target for each of our questions or exams. Then map it with the CO in the question paper itself. Map with the CO and weightage. Total CO weightage we have to find out. Then after finding the total CO weightage and the thing, we have to predict how many students crossed my threshold. Target. Target is 3 marks means how many scored more than 3. Or target is 40 marks means out of end semester 80, 40 marks is my target. How many crossed above 40? So only 20 students out of my 50 crossed means I may not have attainment at all. So that also can happen. So this is what we call as direct, indirect, and overall attainment. Can we go to the next slide? Yeah, so corrective measures. I told you already there will be a DAC, Department Academic Advisory Committee. So they give a corrective measure. Corrective measure means maybe bridge class may be required. There may be prerequisite. Prerequisite means before studying the course, you may have to know what are all the previous courses. So we have to give those courses. Then what are the critical topics? Then what are the solutions? We may have to give like this. So by giving this corrective measures, next time we may get a better CO average. So this is done after attainment. So we calculate CO attainment. These are the values what we got for overall CO attainment. 2.7, 2.73, 2.1, 2.64. So like this we get. I hope all of you are clear. Next slide. Yeah. So similarly, finally for each PO, we take the CO attainments and average it out. So that is where we get the PO attainment. So for total, for a program, we take the outcome. So PO1, it is 2.67. So 2.67, then into 2.72. So what is 2.72? What we got the score. That divided by, what we got the score was 2.72. We multiplied it, divide by 3, we get the attainment level as 2.42. So this is the weighted average. That is why we took the weighted average. Weighted average means we calculated each COs 1, 2, 3, like that we added it, total divided by number of COs, we got a weighted average. So this is weighted average, 2.67, 2. Like this. Now what I do for attainment level calculation of a PO. PO means program. CO means course. So course attainment is from direct exam, then indirect survey. PO attainment is from this each CO attainment multiplied by target divided by 3. That will give us the each PO attainment. So wherever this my target levels are less, 1.67. So 1.67 into 2.72 divided by 3. It is only 1.51. So that much relevance only for PO 11 in that particular course. Here it is 0.91, means very less relevance. But 2.42, this PO 1 and PO 2 have higher relevance. So this is what I basically do for program outcome attainment, course outcome attainment, and then the weighted average calculation. So first, for basically this is the total process of OBE. First, what we have to do, we have to write the COs, then we have to map it with the PO using a course articulation matrix, കോസ് ആർട്ടിക്കുലേഷൻ മാൻ മീൻസ് ഹൗ മച്ച് റെലവൻസ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ കം വി മാർക്ക് നോ 3 2 1 ലൈക് ദാറ്റ് വാല്യൂസ് വി റൈറ്റ് ദെൻ വി ഹാവ് ടു ഫൈൻഡ് ദി വെയ്റ്റഡ് ആവറേജ് ഈച്ച് കോളംസ് ആവറേജ് വി ടേക്ക് ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഓൾസോ റിട്ടൺ ദെൻ വാട്ട് വി ഡു അക്കോർഡിംഗ് ടു സിഒ വി ഡു ദ ടീച്ചിങ് അക്കോർഡിംഗ് ടു ആർട്ടിക്കുലേഷൻ മാട്രിക്സ് ദെൻ വി കണ്ടക്ട് ദി ഡയറക്ട് അസസ്മെന്റ് ഡയറക്ട് അസസ്മെന്റ് മീൻസ് ഈച്ച് എക്സാം അവർ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഇന്റേണൽ second internal assignment attendance all this we conduct and we try to map the each of the CO with each of the question for that for each exam we get a target so how much of our students cross above the target for each of the CO question we try to find out and we map the CO attainment average it out we get the CO attainment after finding the direct CO attainment we conduct the survey and find the indirect so direct into how much weightage 80% means 0.8 if it is indirect into 0.2 20% or if it is direct is 90% means direct into 0.9 plus indirect into 0.1 like that we have to multiply and find the overall CO attainment so after finding the CO attainment then we come to the PO attainment in PO attainment what we do we take that value then multiply that value with the weighted average divided by 3 we get the what is our attainment level of PO for that particular course so this is what we do as PO and CO attainment solution I hope all of you are clear with this it may be slightly difficult in the starting to understand but if you practice with your marks and question it is going to be easy but just understand it is the number of percentage of students who is going to cross the particular set of question mark okay Parvati miss can you share that excel sheet so there is a easy way the original process now I explained now automatically like for those who are doing NBA accreditation they have made one excel sheet where we can directly calculate I think you have to download and open it that's better so this sheet is very handy where we have to just enter our marks and different values automatically it will calculate we need not write a formula to do the calculation so that is the advantage of this excel sheet which has been very handy to most of the teachers who are doing for NBA or NAC assessment you can do it very easily or should I share it ma'am yeah so can you go to the top part give enable editing ma'am just yeah to the top part top so for each course we write the program so program is which we study BSc or BA we write the program then we write the academic year which semester then the course code yesterday I explained you what is the course code then what is the course title so course title may be introduction to communicative english SAR code is also a unique code which I give for this we call this as a self assessment report of a teacher so that is why we called as SAR we give a code unique code for it because if you don't give a unique code finally calculating it for this complete class will be very difficult okay sorry complete program will be very difficult because each program we are going to average total this thing so we wrote it then number of students 20 so how many students are in the class I have tried come down yeah no not that much little up evaluation component little more up to the left side left side little more to the left yeah now a little up Yeah. So here we can see the internal component definition. So very easy to you. So what I do, first internal assessment is for 5 marks. My component out of 100, I give weightage as 5. I conduct the exam out of 40. So I write here 5, 40. Please, if you follow this, very easy it is. 5 is the component weight and 40 is my marks out of which I conduct. Then 10 is assignment and my second assignment and what is that, attendance together. It is for 10 mark. I conduct the exam for 10 mark because I have to entry. So how much mark I will do the mark entry is what is written below. 40, 10, 40 and all. How much is what I am going to do the entry. Then internal assessment is out of 5. Means second internal assessment is out of 5. Your second exam, which is going to be conducted in 40. And end semester is conducted in 80. And it is out of 80. And here this blue part, you should not touch it at all. Wherever there is white only you have to enter, because blue part is a formula written one. So you can see here total is 100. Little more to the right side. To this. Yeah. So here you can see 100 mark, which is found from a formula taking all the assignment. Total is out of 100 we can see. Okay. Total is out of 100. So how we combined 5? Total 5 plus 10 plus 5 plus 80, 80 plus 20, 100 is our total. Can we come to the right side little more? To the left, other side.
One thing, if you can unshare, I will share it, ma'am, little. Are you able to see the screen?
No, sir.
Now?
Yes.
Yeah. So here we can see here that there are this course outcome to evaluation component mapping. So what I do is first I write all my CO statements. So here I can see 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. These are all my CO statements. Means some fundamental statement, some building statement like that, right? Then what I do is, for first internal, how much mark was from CO1? Fundamentals, it was 10 mark. This how will I get, I already showed you the question paper. The question paper, I will take, there are 3 2-mark question, 1 5-mark question, or 2 2-mark question, 1 5-mark question, 2 plus 5. Then 1 objective question, so totally 10. So I should find it and just enter that outcome in this evaluation map. Then for second CO2, CO3. So total is out of 40. If I am entering it properly, here it will show criterion as 1. 1 means my weightage, what already I gave here, is correct. If I have given for 40 weightage, here also it should be 40. So if I make a wrong statement, if I give 4 only here, it is going to be 0. So here you can clearly understand whether you have given the number of COs and mark weightage correctly. But if you feel that some CO may not be mapped properly, try to just adjust and map it. So if I give here 5, or this question, maybe it is for CO 5, I give here 5. So it becomes 40 clearly. So for assignment also, it is from CO2, CO3 and CO4. So 2 plus 3 plus 5. So totally out of 10, it is correct. So it is showing criterion as 1. So similarly, just I have to enter how much. For end semester 80 marks, I am just entering it as 9 plus 23 marks has come from CO2. 22 marks have come from CO1.
11 marks have come from CO4, 5 marks have come from CO5. So totally it is 80 marks. Then what I do is, how much is my internal target going to be? So target I am going to set it as 40. So out of internal, I think 40% of my students are going to score more than 50 marks. 50% of the target. Target mark is 50. So 50 means 50% of the exam mark. Out of that, what I do, I keep it as internal 40, end semester 40. This I can change it to 30 also. This I can lower it down according to the whether the paper is tough or not. So I have to just give the end semester target or end semester what is the thing I want to define for each CO, I can define it. So after entering this internal and end semester, what are my targets? Then I put level 1, upper limit is 40. This is what I told already. 40% of students comes, it is level 1. 60% comes level 2. Above that is level 3. So like that, I can put the level upper limits also. Upper limit is level 1, upper limit is 40. Level 2, upper limit is 60. Level 3 also, if I want to give 80, I can give. And indirect attainment also, I can give the percentage. Instead of directly entering 332 like previous, here we can tell how much percentage they give. So we have given 10 out of 10 is our rating. Okay. And everybody has given average 8 rating. Then I can give indirect attainment percentage is 80. So this I can enter. Direct attainment to indirect attainment, I have made it as 80-20. Or I can make it 90-10 also. Like how we calculated, we can make it 90-10 also. So this is a handy sheet to just do the entry. So this is the toughest part from each of the question paper. Each of the question paper, I have to just map the question to which CO and see that the total marks are coming from all the COs properly. Then I have to just set a target. Target mark and what is my threshold going to be. Threshold is how much percentage of the students will cross the mark in the particular case. Then what I do, I have to give my CO to PO, what we call as the weighted average mapping. So this is articulation matrix. This we would have done at the starting of the course itself. What we do, 2, 1, 2, like that. We enter for all PO and PSOs, we enter. Okay, for all PO and PSO, we just enter the value from what we have made and kept for the starting. This is our course articulation matrix. Articulation means, 2 means that much relevance is there for PO1. 60% relevance. Already I told you, the course articulation matrix, you have to just enter the value. Next, what only process left is to enter the internal marks. So internal exam 1, assignment plus your attendance 1, internal exam 2, end semester. So all for all 20 students, I am going to just enter the marks. So I have entered already the marks. Then automatically this will generate me what I call as the assessment attainment. So here if I see the first CO question, the number of students attend more than threshold is 20. Okay, so all my 20 students were able to score more than my target. What was my target? 0.4 only I kept. So out of that, all my students have got more than 0.4. Okay, so 100% is my attainment level 3. So all this I got level 3. But for my end semester, also I got this because I have entered random marks. When you enter the correct marks, you will be able to get the proper value. So here, this level attainment I can see. This will automatically calculate it. Then total internal plus external. So internal plus external is 85.5, 85.5, 81. Like this, for each of them it will calculate and it will give me combined CO value. So combined CO values, what we calculated is 2.7 is the attainment level for each of them. This is because I have randomly entered a mark to show you. if you enter the proper correct marks, you will be able to get this proper thing. So only here our part is to very easy. What is our part? Just enter the component weightage and what are the things. So you should try to align to internal exam 1, internal exam 2. These two you can combine and enter the marks. Assessment and attendance you can combine and enter. Then what we do next is give the threshold and what are the our mappings. So each question paper you have to check how much mark came from CO1, CO2, CO3, CO4. Just enter it. Similarly for assignments, from which CO you gave, from internal to end semester. So maybe you have to change this attendance because attendance may not map a CO, or you have to write a CO, regularity of a student to that class, maybe a CO, so that you can map the marks to that CO also. Okay, 5 marks you can give for regularity. You take it as CO4 is based on regularity, or CO5 is based on regularity you can give. So like that you have to frame a CO. Then we give this, what is the internal threshold, external threshold. So if I increase the threshold, maybe my percentage may come down. So if I am giving it as 50, okay, for this also I will increase to now 60. If I am entering for all these things, it will change. So based on what I enter here, then I have to give the articulation matrix, my target also. Target also I can change it. After that, here if I go, now this would have changed. Now the percentage of attainment came to 60. Because now I increased my threshold to 0.6. So how many students? Only 12 students out of 20 are able to score. So my attainment changed to 60. So this sheet will directly help you to calculate it. Instead of you putting an effort and calculating each of the students, this will give you a direct calculation. So this is a very handy thing. So now it became 75, 85, 80. Previously it was 100%. When I showed you, all of them were 100% because we had kept the target levels very low, 30% and all. But end semester still now I didn't change much. So it is 85, 85, 85. Then combined also it came down. Then total level also it came to, for CO6 and CO4 it became 1.8 because of my target level change. So like this I have to average and find the target. So finally I get a report. So this is the report what you are going to keep to the our record of CO attainment calculation. So each CO, what is your internal, what is your end semester, what is your direct, what is your indirect, what is your final, what is your target, what you kept, whether you achieved. So these two COs we couldn't achieve because it was only 40%, but we have kept the target as 50. Okay, so like this we have to generate a report. Here PO values also calculated, that weighted average what we calculated, automatically it has been calculated. We need not mug up the formulas or create a sheet. This will be very handy for you to do it. Okay, so this is the easy solution what I have shown you. Maybe multiple time practice. Once you try to give the inputs and all, if you have a doubt, please approach me. I can help you out in doing this. Or maybe one more detailed session we can do on the sheet. Once you have all prepared the marks, your course outcomes, your what is the question paper according to CO, then we can do this within some 5 to 10 minutes. We can easily complete it. It will only take some hardly some 20 minutes to get a CO attainment of a particular course, because we can directly do the entry for each of the thing. So this is what I wanted to explain you today. You should only edit the input sheet. You should not touch the other sheet. Because input sheet, wherever it is marked white, we can enter those values. Wherever it is white, we can enter those values. This threshold also, brown also, we can change the threshold and target. Then we can enter the COPO mapping. Then we can enter the marks of each exam. And then see the
what is the attainment report? So this is the internal report, external report, then the total overall attainment. Similarly, in SAR report also we get the complete picture. So we told about how we calculate CIE manually and with this sheet also. This sheet will make the process very easy for you. I hope all of you are clear, but definitely you may have to practice it one or two times. But just try to align your course with the course outcomes, program outcomes, then each exam with particular COs. So this is about the sheet. If you can try with this sheet, it becomes very easy for you. So I have shared the sheet with Parvati ma'am. So you can ask with her, Parvati madam, you can get it. First you form a course outcome properly, program outcome properly, then do the articulation matrix, then conduct the exam. As I told, we have to map each of our question to corresponding COs and do the exam. Write the question paper, write the corresponding CO, give the weightage, give the Bloom's taxonomy. If you are able to write all that things together, then it is only process of just entering into this sheet, you get the outcome. Outcome is telling that this much percentage of students crossed this much mark. The manual tabulation I had shown you in the PPT, this Excel sheet does it automatically. So this is what totally OBE attainment process is. CO attainment we saw, PO attainment we saw, mapping we saw, how the suggestions are given we saw, indirect, direct. So more than this, it is all about your effort of putting it up and practicing. There are many good video lectures on this OBE kind of things. You can also listen to them, or maybe a recorded session of this. You try to listen, put your this and practice. All of us are teachers, so we will quickly try to understand and analyze it and easily do it. So when you do this time your course plan, try to make, I will show you a sample course plan and stop this thing. So here, just a second, I will open a course plan and show you. So this is generally how we make a course plan in this. So there is, we can see the course code, course title, everything given. Then what is the course code plus CO1 is written as the entry for each. Then what is the course outcome? So course outcome is provide basic concepts of some particular topic. That is the L1 Bloom's taxonomy. Then I have written all my program outcomes. You can see there are 12 program outcomes for me and there are 5 COs for me. Then I have mapped 5 CO to this particular 6 or 12 program outcomes which are relevant. I have done the mapping and I have put the weightages 3, 2, 1 like that. I have put the weightages. Then for CO attainment, I write what is the CO, what is the, which all POs it maps. It maps to 1, 2, 5, 7. Then I have put whether it has a practical, whether it has a lab, I have just ticking, or whether it has a project or assignment. So if there is a practical lab paper, I have to put a lab tick here. If it is only a theory, I have to just put a tick theory. If it has some assignment, I have to put a tick. So like this, I will plan my assignment. Then I will write a concept map. Concept map means how I am going to divide the topic and take. So my initial is basic concepts. After that, I divide it into 7 different areas. Then I take the class accordingly. So like that, I will divide. Then each lecture-wise plan we will make. So each lecture hour, what is the topic I teach? What is the keyword? What is my learning objective? What is my corresponding course outcome? This will be very easy because once you write the CO outcomes here, that will help us to map to the question paper. If I have asked something from the introduction part, I know it is CO1.
if I have asked something from the other part, some mathematical part, I know it is CO2. Otherwise, I know it is CO3. So like that for all the classes. How many? It is a 60-hour 4-credit course. So 60-hour, all 60 hours, I have made the like the lesson plan detailed with CO mapping for each of the topic, so that I know that all my COs are covered properly. Then I have given the textbook. Then I have given my exam pattern. Internal exam, periodical one is internal exam. Internal exam, external exam, total is 50-50 in our case. Your case is 80-20. So like that I map. Then what is my examination mode I write? Internal exam, external exam, end semester. Like that I write for each of them. This is how I prepare a course plan. So if you follow your course plan like this, then it becomes very easy for you to finally what do your like the subject mapping. So you have to create a course map with your COPO, COPO mapping, then each topic mapping to which CO, then similarly question paper mapping to CO, then just it's some part of just entering it into the Excel sheet and calculating how much percentage of student crossed. So this is what the OBE attainment total process. I hope all of you are clear. I have made it a little fast because our time duration is less, but I hope all of you have got an idea. Maybe once you practice with one subject, it will be easy for you. So now session is open for queries. If there is anything, you can ask. Any queries, any doubts? I know definitely doubts will be there because it is a concept, but if there's anything you can ask about the things, you can ask me. Any doubts, anything?
Sir, I think it will be clear if we do the calculation.
Yeah. That is what, like, you can...
But we have to do that. Only then it will become clear.
Yes, you can... First, you have to enter all the things. Then you will understand how much percentage of your students will go to which levels.
Okay, sir.
So, you should be ready with... When you sit for this calculation, you should be ready with your course plan. As I showed you, what is with CO, PO, PO, PSO mapping, everything should be ready. Then you should have your marks with you. You should have your question paper with you. All the three things are with you means you can directly get your how many students crossed which marks.
Okay.
I think you can conduct an exercise in your college by sitting, all of you sitting in a group and try to do this. Then come up with a little more understanding. Then we can try to have one more interaction like this, or an informal interaction. If you want, we can have it like that and try to clear it out.
Okay, sir.
Any other queries?
The session is open for discussion. You may ask your doubts. Either you can unmute yourself and ask, or you can type the question in the chat box. If you don't have anything else to ask our resource person, let me invite Dr. Preetha Pillai, Faculty, Department of Botany, to give a feedback.
A very good evening to all. Let me say first, Manishankar sir, you explained minutely each topic, although I'm going to present a feedback about definitely still I'm going to make any mistakes, just forgive me. Because you explained very well, sir. The day one, you explained the program outcome, program specific outcome, and the course outcome, which I understood that it is the program outcome, which is examine what a program or the process is to do, achieve or accomplish for its own improvement. And the program specific outcome, students will have to ability to apply specific skills and its effective use of different areas. And the course outcome, which defines the specific subject or the course, which should be specific and measurable statement that defines knowing the skills and attitude of the learners. Sir, we learn the program outcome, program specific outcome, which leads to the curriculum. Individual curriculum consists different components and which leads to different courses. And finally, it is termed as the course outcome. The course outcome also defines, describe, develop, apply, interpret, and develop the course outcome. You also made us aware about the course articulation metrics, which really we need to do lots of practice. Still, we are thinking that the way you have explained, definitely it is essential to us to learn it. And the assessment procedures also, you explained that also we need to learn more. The second day of the workshop, you elaborated as the course outcome attainment. It is about the assessment pattern, and which is direct assessment, indirect assessment, and the course and the semester feedback systems and all. Which out of this, I understood the course outcome attainment target levels. Sir, you explained the teachers need to set a target levels, level 1, level 2, and level 3, which you have explained. The level 1, which is which should under 60 and 70% of the students, which are those who are scoring the marks below 3. And the level 2, 80 to 89% of the students scoring marks, then 3 marks. And the level 3, 90% of the students, those who are scoring marks. So next, further we understood the completion of the course direct attainment system, calculation methods, evaluation methods of the students, how to do the direct attainment procedures, descriptive examination data preparation. So you exceptionally defined the calculation method, although it is very easy for you, but really we need to adapt it and learn it many more times. But we are assuring you, we will learn it, then only it will be used in the effective way. Definitely we will try our level best to do it, sir. Further, you explained the course attainment, which refers how many students attempted, number of students crossed the target, hence will get attainment level, computation of course indirect attainment level. It is really need to do lots of practice, sir, to bring best out of this. Course outcome corrective measurements, we learned direct examination, indirect examination procedures and all. In between day one more fascinating things we learned, I forgot to explain that. That was the Bloom's taxonomy, which we really need to improve it. Remember, understand, apply, analyze, evaluate and create. That was really fascinating, sir. In that you have explained, recall facts and basic concepts, explain ideas or concepts, use information in new situations, draw connections among ideas, justify a stand or decisions, procedures, new and original works. These were your Bloom's taxonomy, which were analyzing or explaining about it. And for the second day, the course statement you could write with at the marks, sorry, course statement which we need to write overall statement procedure, which we need to describe, develop, apply, and interpret and develop the procedures. At the end, marks need to enter it. Definitely, you explain the calculation very well, but I think as you said, the multiple time practice need to do it. Definitely, I think one more class is required, I think, sir. So we are thankful for this, sir. We learned this much. I think justified what you have explained with that. Last, so I can conclude that the purpose of the workshop has been completely accomplished. It's been a pleasure being with all of you today. Thank you, sir, for spacing your valuable time for this 2 days workshop with us. Thank you, organizers, for organizing latest innovative and needy topics amongst us. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Preeta ma'am. For your kind information, the feedback link is posted there in the chat box. You can fill the feedback form and your certificates will be sent to your mail very soon. It is now time to thank all of you who are here making this workshop a success. Let me begin by thanking Dr. Srijit CM, Controller of Examinations, MG University, who inaugurated this workshop. And now I thank our resource person, Dr. Manishankar S. I feel so happy and proud at this moment to thank him for being here. I know personally how dedicated a teacher he is, and he had put all that effort to explain us what outcome-based education is with all these calculations and things like that. And he has shared that Excel sheet with me. I will share it with the mail IDs that I've got for all the participants and in the college mail also. And I would congratulate him for the success that he achieved as a coordinator in his college, which got NAC A++ grade very recently, just 2 weeks back. So I take this opportunity to congratulate him and thank him for spending time with us and explaining this tedious, difficult outcome-based education. Thank you, sir. Allow me to thank our dear principal, Dr. M.R. Renuka, who encouraged and supported us all through this workshop. Thank you, ma'am. I now thank our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Preeti Kayan, who is constantly working hard to make our institution the best. Thank you, ma'am. Let me thank all the heads of the department of SPRNSS College, especially Professor Jayaraj for his constant advice and encouragement, and Dr. Jayakumar of Department of Botany, who proposed thanks for the inaugural session. I thank all the fellow teachers of SPRNSS College for their support. With much respect and love, I thank all the participants from all over India who are here for the past 2 days to participate in this workshop, and your interactive participation made this a huge success. So thank you all. I take this opportunity to give a special thanks to Mr. Babin, Faculty Department of Mathematics, and Ms. Krishnapriya, Faculty Department of Economics, and Dr. Preeta Pillai, Faculty Department of Botany, who had rendered all the technical support and help for this workshop. I thank everybody who had helped me through this workshop. I thank everyone once again. Thank you all.